Robin Hood and Little John walking through the forest, laughing back and forth at what the other has to say. Reminiscing this and that and having such a good time. Oodle-lolly, oodle-lolly, golly, what a day. Never ever thinking there was danger in the water they were drinking, they just guzzled it down. Never dreaming that a scheming sheriff and his posse was watching them and gathering around. Robin Hood and Little John running through the forest, jumping fences, dodging trees and trying to get away. Contemplating nothing but escaping, finally making it. Oodle-lolly, oodle-lolly.
Good morning.
Good wet morning.
Yeah. I was just sitting here thinking, and, you know, it's not that cold. It's like, what is it?
43.
But it feels like it's very cold. And so I think everybody says, well, it's a dry cold. You don't notice it. That's really true.
We don't have that.
No, this is like 100% humidity right now.
Well, yeah, it's raining.
Yeah, and it's going right through. So, we got our new signs. We're with, here we go. That's us.
Can you see past the... Do we need higher?
Okay, anyway.
Well, yeah. I get the idea.
Yeah, you get the idea.
So we're officially Ideal Real Estate.
Yeah, Ideal. Formerly Keller Williams, before that Coldwell Banker, and now we're Ideal.
Before that, we were dental hygienists.
Yeah. No sign for that, you know. So this is, we're Brent and Amy Powell with Home Team Powell, and we have a weekly YouTube channel every Saturday morning. We
obviously
record these.
Obviously you figured that out since you're watching.
Yeah, well, I mean, if you're brand new, we like it if you hit the like and the subscribe. We're now pushing 500 subscribers.
Whoop, whoop.
And we'll have another
giveaway.
Yeah.
So this is something
that Logan makes. These awesome handmade leather thingamajigs. This is
what do they call it when you do it with your feet?
Hacky sack. Yeah, but this is
the ball.
Yeah, this is just a ball. So Logan knows it's not a regulation hacky sack for those of you that are into it.
Does anybody hacky sack anymore?
I don't know.
I've not seen anybody.
That was big a while back.
Yeah.
So what we do every week, we cover those homes in the North Olympic Peninsula that have closed in the last 7 days. And it kind of gives us a feeling for what the market's doing. And it's sort of been languishing. We have a few more today.
And it'll give you, it's for your benefit, so you understand pricing, where it's going, are they going over asking, all that stuff. So.
Yeah, and we usually give our... wholly unofficial gut feeling of where the market is and where it's going at some point in use most every week telecast. So anyway,
okay.
You
well, this week we have 10 homes have closed, which is sold in the North Olympic Peninsula. Two of them in Port Angeles. We're really low here, and 8 in Sequim.
Yeah, so usually it takes from 2 weeks to 6 weeks to close from the initial time when it goes under contract. Cash sales, which
are
quicker. Yeah, can be up to as little as two weeks. And if it's financed, depending on how complicated it is, that can take up to 6 weeks. So there's a 2 to 6 week lag. You know, these represent where prices were last year. And this will be the last...
About 6 weeks ago.
Yeah, the last group of homes that have closed at the end of 2023.
No, these closed, there were just a few days last year that are part of this.
Okay. So we start with the lesser expensive homes and move to those higher, more expensive. And we'll start off in Port Angeles. The first one is on View Ridge Drive, and this one... originally priced for $579,000, sold for $570,000. 3 bedrooms, 3 baths, 24 days on the market, built in 1994, 2,206 square feet, and just a little under a half an acre, and they have a territorial view.
All right, and this This is above the S-curves, if you know where that is in Port Angeles. The next, second one, and then last one in Port Angeles is on Deer Run. It's a manufactured home listed for $650, and it sold for $570. Okay. A three-bedroom, two-bath, 123 days on the market. Built in 05 with 2537 square feet on 3.4 acres and a territorial view.
Yeah, so this is pretty consistent on a home that stays on the market longer.
How much did it drop?
That dropped by $80,000. So some people are fishing. You know, they just put their house on the market for too much money and they don't need to sell it really. But they're looking for people that are willing to pay too much money. So they just sit there. Other people who are above the market, for whatever reason, usually the seller thinks their homes are worth more than the market value. So eventually they get the message, and you know, after a couple, 2, 3, 4 months on the market, they end up lowering the price. Okay, the next one is the first home in Sequim. And this is on Martin Road, and originally priced for $350,000. Sold for $15,000 over, 365, one bedroom. Looks like a kind of a small place, cabin-ish. One bath, 6 days on the market. So somebody really liked this place. Built in 2007, 480 square feet, and it sits on 1.61 acres. Territorial view.
And the second house in Sequim is on Cottonwood Lane, originally listed for $395. It sold for $387.5. Two bedrooms, 2.5 baths, 28 days on the market, built in 1978, with 1,691 square feet on a 0.43 of an acre and a mountain view. Okay. And this is, did I say manufactured? This is manufactured.
I can't remember. Okay. Yeah. Okay, Hooker Road, and that goes up into the foothills, so it looks like a nice place. Originally priced for $474,950 and sold for $395,000. That's just a little under $80,000 less once yeah. again. And five bedrooms, small or large place, three baths, 108 days on the market, built in 1971 with 2,186 square feet. And they are on a quarter of an acre, and they have neighborhood view.
Excellent.
Excellent.
Yeah, I mean they. Yeah.
Yeah.
And the fourth house in Port in Sequim is on El Camino Drive, originally listed for $485. It sold for $457,250. I don't know where people get these little funny numbers. Three bedrooms, 2.5 baths, 45 days on the market. Built in 1980 with 2388 square feet on 0.41 of an acre and a neighborhood view.
On the page house. Two.
I think. Rush. Yeah. Rush liked to do shuffle.
Yeah. Okay, Coral Drive and Scrim on the market originally for 611,000 square feet. And.
No.
I mean,
square dollars.
I'm still working on the reading part of this job. Okay, so big house. Okay, take two on that one.
That would be Bill Gates or something.
Yeah. Okay, $611,000 sold for $540, $71,000 under, and four bedrooms, three baths, 42 days on the market, built in 1999. Nice size home, 2,616 square feet on a little under a quarter of an acre with saltwater and mountain view.
Okay. Next house is a condo townhouse, one or the other, in Sunland. It's on Fairway Drive, listed for $599,999, and it sold for $585. Two bedrooms, 2.5 baths, 7 days on the market. Built in 1991 with 2,771 square feet on, it's a condo, so you don't own the land, and it's on a golf course.
Yeah. Okay. Very good. Good. Yeah. Excellent. So.
What was that from? What movie?
Excellent choice.
I don't know.
Oh, it was a comedy sketch from Michael Regan.
Mr. Bean or something?
No. Something that was actually funny. Okay, this is on Willow. Originally priced at $585,000, sold at asking, three bedrooms, two baths. One day on the market, this baby flew right off, 2017, square feet. I got the square feet thing. 2000, built in 2017.
Everything's a square foot.
Yeah, 1,629 square feet, and it's on a quarter of an acre.
Neighborhood. Sure. It's not a quarter of a million.
Quarter of a square foot.
Yeah. And taking us home, the final house is on Willow Street, East Willow. Listed for $575,000. It actually sold over asking for $586,500. Three bedrooms, two baths, one day on the market. Built in 1995 with 1963 square feet. On 0.21 of an acre in a mountain view.
Yeah.
So that here endeth the report of the homes sold this week.
Okay. So Amy did some summarizing of the stats, and you want to go
for it?
Okay. So this last week we had two homes in Port Angeles close and eight in Sequim. Only one was. Didn't we have more than one over asking?
Two.
We had two over asking.
This was the second one.
Yeah, two over asking. Most of them, or four of them, went under contract on the first week.
Yeah, four out of ten.
Yeah, several were longer. The longest was 100.
Pretty brisk market.
Pretty brisk market?
If four out of ten sold first day.
Yeah, but six out of ten lasted a long time. So
No, not long.
Well,
24 days.
Yeah,
you know.
123 days.
That's the longest. Okay.
Yeah. Anyway, we have to work this out between us, our perceptions.
You love it.
No.
You love it when we jibber jabber.
Well, we don't know what they love or not, but anyway, at least you keep watching. Thank you for that. Okay, then last year, summaries of the year, there was 1,039 properties sold, and that includes land and homes, dwellings.
In all of the North Peninsula.
Yeah, North Peninsula. And 74 condo townhouses, 135 manufactured, and 780 site-built. And of that 1,039 properties, 415 were in Port Angeles area, and 586 were in Sequim. So just a quick reminder, if you're new to our channel, all of the photos that we use to represent these homes are from the county. They're public domain. And almost all of the homes look better than the photos because the photos can be some time ago, 3 or 4 or 5 years ago.
Yeah.
Many of these have been updated and spruced up. And so you look at the homes that we show and you think it's sold for how much? Well, it's better than it appears. We can't really.
Zillow would give you a more accurate picture.
Yeah,
of the because they have had permission from each realtor.
Okay, so
what else? Brent has a ankle rebuild surgery coming up the end of February, so we probably won't have a show on the first Saturday in March.
In March, yeah, because
he's going to be on the recliner.
Yeah, I'll be in it. Anyway, I should be able to make the one after that. So we're still on the home stretch for our little house behind us, which you can see.
Little house on the alley.
Little house on the alley. We should write a book or something. And
we're at the point of securing the cabinets, then the floors will be laid and trim will be put on, and then I can do my thing.
Yeah, and the quartz. Gets the template made next week and probably 2 weeks to get the quartz countertops in.
So we're pushing to get everything done before his surgery. So
yeah, won't happen, but we're pushing anyway.
Well, I'm going to leave you in there, and I'm going to go fuss.
Yeah, yeah. So. Well, good. Hope you have a great week. We're hoping for better weather coming up soon, warmer.
Yeah. And so we don't really, Logan hasn't decided what to do for the intro yet, so that's why we didn't mention it. He'll come up with something good. He's good. And
okay, closing comments.
It's supposed to be nice tomorrow. It's boring right now.
Anyway.
Call us. That was Logan's little ball that just went in front. Oh, I know. What was the thought I had? How are you all doing with understanding the new requirements for a buyer's and the buyer agency agreement?
Yeah.
So if you still have questions, let us know. We've moved past it, but we can sure go back.
Yeah. So we are. If you are local, we are going to have an open house when our ADU is completed, and that'll be sometime in March, I'm thinking, by the time it's finally done.
Yeah.
And if you would like to be invited to that, just make a comment, and we will send you our physical address. And we're not wanting...
We've had one so far.
Yeah, we've had one eager soul. So we'd love to have you come, and might be a good opportunity to meet you and have some
snacks,
some nice snacks. You know, I used to...
And check out our realm.
Yeah, I used to, as a young single guy, I would choose which events I'd go to based on what the snacks were going to be like.
Well,
but I know you, you're not like that.
We won't comment on what that means.
Yeah, I know. I was hungry. I never
sort
made
of
too
sad.
Much. Yeah. But
anyway.
It's something else. Is there anything else?
Not that I can't wait, I think.
Yeah, okay. Well, hey, have a great week.
Oh, we did go on our first bike ride.
Okay, yeah.
This week.
Yeah, bike ride. So
It was 56 out, and for January, that's sweet. And we went on our bike ride down along the waterfront till the side of the hill had collapsed and covered the pathway. So
no, it was
waves.
Debris from the beach.
Yeah, from that big storm.
We had a huge storm surge, and usually where we ride, you know, we can go 10 miles, 5 out, 5 back. This time we could only go like 3 out because the wind and the waves just totally obliterated the Olympic Discovery Trail. It's going to take them a while to clean that up. So, anyway, so once again, here comes the closing comments. Hope you have a great week. Thanks for tuning in. We'll see you back in a week.
Bye.